Hello everyone, this is Jeff of TAOFLEDERMAUS. We finally made it to the last of the clone metal slugs. Identical slugs made out of seven different metals. And in this video, we're going to show the brass round. These weigh in just about 1 ounce. They're just slightly lighter than the copper rounds, which were the heaviest of the metals. The lightest, if you remember, was aluminum. And we couldn't have done this without the creativity and the generosity of Tim from Tactical G-Code, who machined all these fine slugs for us. It's been a lot of fun for us to test these out because there's been a lot of little surprises here and there. So let's get down to it and shoot them. Our first target is this 8-inch ball of ballistic gel. Kind of looks like an eyeball or a pig or something, not sure. When we filmed this, we thought Darren just didn't get a good dead center hit, maybe pulled the gun a little bit. So let's look at the other footage and see what really happened. And this is a real weird one for several reasons. The rounds that Tim made have typically been pretty accurate, and they've flown relatively straight. Some of them have wobbled, but none of them have done this. For about half of its flight, it went sideways, and then it just started steering back onto course. Really weird. It was like from that stupid movie Wanted or something where the bullets curve. Our next target is our disc of lead, 3/4 inch thick and 7 inches in diameter.
I think he went right in the center, buddy.
Darren got a nice clean near the center shot there, and that round went right through 3/4 inch of lead. Now this round was accurate, but it wobbled around a little bit. This round definitely had enough weight or mass and enough speed to punch right through that lead. That little disc of lead weighs 10 pounds, by the way, so it didn't move very much when we hit it. We were able to find this slug. It was right on the table underneath the plate. It was a little bit mushed up. And this is the back side of the plate. The other dent that I'm pointing to there is from the aluminum slug that we shot the other day. I took some calipers and measured this slug, and it expanded about 85 thousandths of an inch. And you can see the lead has been fused to the nose, but it's in remarkable shape for something that just punched through a thick lead plate. Our next target is 6 dollar store watermelons. Yeah, I splurged on this one. I went over my $5 budget, folks.
How heavy are these?
A little less than an ounce.
Okay.
Wow. Wow. Six, that's for sure.
And it came back
about half.
Yeah.
This is the
Oh, look, it's kind of bulged out a little bit.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
It's not perfectly round.
Yeah, it's still shiny. That's the one I used Brasso on. That's amazing. So it bounced off the watermelon. Let's see how many watermelons it went through.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're leaking watermelon juice. Went through the middle of all these, and for some reason on this guy, went outside.
Oh, it deviated.
Yeah.
And it most of the energy was killed. I'm glad we have the high-speed camera on this side, because we may be able to see what's going on. And then the round...
It took the sticker and...
Yeah, stripped the sticker off.
Just punched a little, or kind of dented it.
Yeah, and it was still going... It was still flying straight at that point. So... The fly, Mr. Fly, sure likes it.
Now, in retrospect, I should have put this camera more to the side as a side profile shot, but these watermelons were blowing apart probably 20 feet in every direction, so I was just trying to keep it from getting sprayed. Now, this round, you can kind of see it rising and falling a little bit. It did a little dip there and rose back up. We got some really unusual results with these slugs this time. And a lot of people will comment thinking that we are shooting about 10 feet away, and we're not. We're shooting at least 20 yards away. When you're zooming in with the cameras, it really throws off your perception. Be sure to check out our playlist showing the six other metal slugs that we shot. And also check out Tim's channel. He does his own shooting tests. He shows you how these rounds are made, and you'll be able to get a kind of a preview of what rounds we'll be shooting next. Thanks for watching.